Hey, I'm Isidor, a developer on the Visual Studio Online Monaco team, and I would like to show you how to quickly edit your ASP.NET Windows Azure website using Visual Studio Online Monaco. In Monaco team, one of our goals was to enable developers to quickly fix any issues they might be seeing on their ASP.NET website running on Windows Azure. Let's assume we have created a site, enabled VS Online Monaco, and pulled in the sources from a Git repository. In our case, we are using a multi-project solution for a visitor's application that can be used for scheduling visits inside my company. The great thing about using Monaco is that the setup is simple. All we need to do is set the virtual directory variable to point to your ASP.NET app root. This is similar to specifying the startup project in a multi-project solution in Visual Studio. If you forgot to do so, we will warn you in the Monaco output window. We can now easily make changes online and test them out. So here is my visitor's app. In this application, there is a web API that returns information about a specific visit. If I try to use it, I'm prompted to authenticate. Since, during development, I don't want to authenticate all the time, I will make the web API easier to access. So let's change the code to disable authorization. Using Quick Open, I can easily find authorization attribute, which is responsible for authenticating requests. Let's make it less restrictive and make the API immediately accessible. Now we just need to build our code. For this, we can run msbuild in the Monaco console. The msbuild will pick up the solution file and build it. While developing, it is convenient to dock the console on the side of our editor. It seems like I forgot to put a semicolon at the end of a line. You can notice that msbuild output errors are navigable and can quickly take me to the location of the error. Let's fix the issue and rebuild. Notice that error navigation only works when you set the generate full paths build option in your project file. Changes will be picked up immediately, so all we need to do is refresh. I now see the result of the query being returned as a JSON object without authentication. All of this is available now for your sites as well, so check it out and let us know what you think using our feedback functionality. Thanks!